welcome you all to the online classes of Tribeni Memorial Senior Secondary School. Okay, so today we are going to start a new chapter. It is chapter number 15 of class 6. Name of our chapter is Air Around Us. As the name suggests, in this chapter we are going to learn about everything in this atmosphere which is surrounding you. What is it in atmosphere which is surrounding it? It is nothing but air. And we are going to study about different components of the air. Okay. So let us start this chapter. So in chapter 9 we have learned that all the living things require air. And which component of the air? Oxygen. Okay. What is the very foremost and the first property of the air which we all know? It is that we can feel the air but we cannot see the air. Okay, so you must have felt its presence in so many ways. You notice when it moves the leaves, when it rustles the clothes, when the leaves of the tree rustle, you know it, and the cloth hanging on the cloth line sway, right? You have been seeing all these processes, moving pages. How does all this thing move? Because of the presence of this air around us, okay? Pages of open book being fluttering when fan is switched on, the moving air make it possible for you to fly your kite also. Okay? So do you remember in activity 3, chapter 5, in which you have separated the sand and the sawdust by winnowing with the help of a winnower? In the chapter separation of substances, we have learned this that winnowing process in which air is responsible for separation of your particles. So in that way also air is used. Winnowing is most effective way in moving air. Okay, you may have noticed that during strong wind blows at very high speed, you know that it may even uproot trees and blow off rooftops. Okay, have you ever played firki? Have you seen the firki? So in moving firki, air is required. Okay, now activity number one. Let us make a firki of our own following the instructions. So very first, hold a stick of the firki and place it in a different direction in the open area. You will see, this is firki. You will see when you place it in the open area, it will start moving. Move it little back and forth, observe what happens. Does the firki rotate? Yes, it will rotate. What makes firki rotate? Moving air. Obviously, moving air makes the firki rotate. Have you ever seen weathercock? This is a diagram of a weathercock. It shows the direction in which air is moving. It helps us to know the direction of the moving air. And moving air is wind. Wind is nothing but moving air. Okay? Now, next question is air present everywhere around us? Let's find out in this section. Close your fist. What do you have in it? Nothing. When you close your fist, what do you have? Nothing. Try the following activity and try it out. Take an empty glass bottle. Is it really empty or does it have something inside? Turn it upside down. Is something inside it now? No, nothing is inside that. But now dip it, the open mouth of the bottle into bucket filled with water as shown in 15.4. Observe the water. Does the water enter in the bottle? Now tilt the bottle gently. Does the water now enter in the bottle? Do you see bubbles coming out of it? If it was really empty, how can these bubbles are coming out of this bottle? So we can say that when you see any bottle empty, it's not really empty. Air is always inside it. Even when you make a fist, air is always inside your hand. Okay? So, can you now guess what was in the bottle? It was air. Yes, it was air. That was the presence of the air. The bottle was not empty at all. In fact, it was filled with completely air even when you turn it upside down. Okay? That is why you notice that water does not enter in the bottle when it is in inverted position. Why water was not entering? Because bottle was not empty. Because it was having air inside it. Okay? As there was no space for air to escape, when you tilt that bottle, when you are having inverted bottle, there was no way for that air to move. But when you tilt it, air was coming out of this bottle and water was replacing that air. That's why air was replacing in this experiment as the air bubbles. Okay. This activity shows that air occupies space. It fills all the space in the bottle. It is present everywhere. First property of air, it is present everywhere. Second property, it occupies space. Air has third property, no color. One can see through it. It is transparent. So fourth property has been done. First one is air is transparent. Air occupies space. Air is lightweighted also. Okay. And next is air has no color. Okay. Our earth is surrounded by thin layer of air. Okay. Our entire earth is surrounded by thin layer of this air. This layer extends up to many kilometers above the surface of the earth, and this is known as atmosphere. So what is atmosphere? Thin layer of air surrounding the earth. Okay. Now, do you think mountaineers carry oxygen cylinder with them while climbing a high mountain? Why they do so? Why oxygen is required for such mountaineers? Let us see. This kind of cylinder is always carried by mountaineers whenever they want to climb up on the mountain, because as we go up in the mountain, as we go at the uppermost region of this earth, the level of the oxygen in the atmosphere become diminished or lower. That's why, and we cannot survive without oxygen. That's why all the mountaineers carry such bag with them which is having oxygen, okay, to survive in low oxygen region. What is air made up of? Until 18th century, people thought that air was just one substance, right? Experiment have proved that it is really not so. Air is a mixture of many gases. Air is not a single substance, it is a mixture of many gases, okay? Let us find out about some of the major components of the mixture one by one. Very first is water vapor. We have learned in water chapter about water cycle. So, during evaporation stage, water will be converted into gaseous form in the form of water vapor. And this water vapor is always present in the atmosphere. So, first component of this atmosphere is water vapor. We also saw that when air comes in contact with cool surface, whenever air comes in contact with cool surface, it condenses and drops into water. Appear on the cool surface. The presence of water vapor in air is important for the water cycle in nature. Okay. The significance of water vapor is in water cycles. Next is oxygen. You all are aware of oxygen. We need oxygen for our survival. We need oxygen for burning. Oxygen is one of the most important component of the air. Okay, let's study it in activities 3. In the presence of the teacher, fix two small candles of the same size in the middle of shallow container. Now fill the container with some water, light the candle, and then cover each of them with an inverted glass, one much taller than another, like this. Okay, one is taller and one is smaller. Observe carefully what happened to the burning candle in the water level. Do the candle continue to burn even when continue to burn or go off? Does the level of water inside the gas remain the same? What is the result of this experiment? Burning of the candle must be due to presence of some component of air, isn't it? Why? Because in the absence of that component, burning stops. Do you find a difference in your observation with the two glasses of different height? What can be the reason for that? The reason is burning occurs only in presence of oxygen. Oxygen is required for burning. This is the reason. We see that. So, we can say that one of the component of atmosphere or air is oxygen. Okay. First one is water vapor. Second is oxygen. Now, the amount of air enhances oxygen. Okay. It was oxygen that is inside glass of our experiment. And it is limited because we have covered that candle in the closed container. So, when most of the oxygen used up by the burning, it is no longer available for burning, and that's why the candle flame will blow out. Also, some of the space occupied by oxygen inside the glass become empty and water rises up to fill or occupy this space. Okay. Now, next component is nitrogen. Okay. gas bottle even if the candle blew out. This indicates presence of some other gases in the air but does not support burning. Right? Component of air which support burning is oxygen. Nitrogen does not support burning. The major part of the air which does not support burning is nitrogen. It takes up 1/4 of the space in that air fills. Okay? Air was still there even when the candle blows off. That component which is present there which do not support burning is nitrogen. Okay? Next is carbon dioxide. In a closed room, if there is some material that is burning, you may have felt suffocation. You feel suffocation when something is burning inside a closed room. This is due to excess of carbon dioxide that may be accumulated in that room. Okay? As the burning continues, carbon dioxide makes up small component of the air. As compared to oxygen and nitrogen, the carbon dioxide is a little less in the air. Okay? It makes a small component. Plants and animals consume oxygen for respiration and produce carbon dioxide as a product. So it's kind of waste material. Plant and animal matter on burning also consume oxygen, produce carbon dioxide. On burning also, things require oxygen and it will release carbon dioxide and few other gases. And carbon dioxide, though it is required by plants also for photosynthesis. I hope you know that. Because we have studied that. Next component of air is dust and smoke. Burning of fuel also produces smoke. Smoke contains a few gases and fine dust particles, and it is harmful when that load of air smoke and dust is present in the air. We call that area polluted. Okay? This is why you see long chimney in the factories and in your home also. They take up all the harmful smoke and gases and they will release it outside, okay? But bring it close to the birds flying up in the sky, but it is not good for the birds which are flying outside. Chimney is saving the people who are working in that factories, but it is not saving the birds, okay? So harmful gas, once released, it will cause harm one or in another way, okay? Dust particles are always present in the air. Some people are allergic to such dust particles, okay? Now, let us study activity number 4. Find a sunny room in your school or your home. Close all the doors and window with the curtains pulled down to make the room dark. Now, open the door or a window facing sun. Just a little in such a way that it allows sunlight to come inside. Enter the room only through the slit, like this. Look carefully in the incoming beam of light. Do you see some tiny shiny dust particle moving in a beam of sunlight? Yes, because dust particles are always there in the atmosphere. During cold winter, you might have observed some beam of light filter through the trees in the dust particle. Okay? This shows that air also contains dust particles. The presence of dust particle in air varies from time to time and from place to place. Some places are having the load of dust particle, such places are polluted places, okay? Some places are having less amount of dust particle, they are much cleaner as comparatively. We inhale air while we breathe in through the nostril. Fine hair and mucus are present inside our nose to prevent dust particle from getting inside our respiratory system, okay? Buju is asking, why do you think policeman is wearing a mask? Nowadays, we all are wearing a mask, not because of dust particles, but because of corona. But even before the corona, we used to wear masks because of pollution, okay? Mask save us from all the dust particles surrounding us. In some area where pollution is high, we should always wear masks to protect ourselves. Such mask is always worn by policemen. Okay? Do you recall being scolded by your parents when you breathe through your mouth? Why? Because such fine hair are not present in your mouth, but they are present in your nose. So your nose protect your body from all those dust particles. Okay? It will not allow the dust particle to go inside your system. But mouth is not having such fine hair. So it will not protect you. So we should always breathe through our nose only. Okay? You may conclude that air contains some gases, water vapor and dust particle. The gases in the air are mainly nitrogen, oxygen, some amount of carbon dioxide and many other gases. However, there may be some variation in composition of air from place to place. Now, we see that air contains mostly nitrogen and oxygen. In fact, these two gases together make up 99% of all the atmosphere, all the air. You can see the composition. Nitrogen, it is around 70%, okay? Oxygen around 20%. So together they will make 90% of the air, and 10% is made up by other gases, okay? Like argon gas is also there, and many more gases are also there with carbon dioxide and water vapor, okay? Remaining gases just make 1%, okay? Now, how does oxygen become available to animal and plant living in water and soil? So, let us do an activity to know the answer. Take some water in a glass vessel or a beaker, heat it slowly on the tip stand well before the water begin to boil. Look carefully in the inner surface of the vessel. What you will see? Do you see tiny bubbles on the inside? These bubbles come out of the air dissolved in the water. Okay? When you heat the water, it begin with the air dissolving it. Try to escape. As you continue heating, water itself turn into vapor and finally begin to boil. In chapter 8 and 9, we have studied that animal living in water use the dissolved oxygen in the water. Okay? The organisms that live in the soil also need oxygen. And so, for respiration, how do they get that air they need for respiration? Let us study that through our next activity. For that, you have to take a lump of dry soil in a beaker or a glass, add water to it and note what happens. Do you see bubbles coming out of the soil? These bubbles indicate presence of air in the soil. Okay? When the water is poured on the lump of the soil, it displays the air which is seen in the form of bubbles. The organisms that live inside the soil and plant root respire through the air which is dissolved air in the soil only. A lot of burrows and holes are formed in the deep of the soil by the animals living in the soil so that they will get the oxygen. This burrow also make up space available for air to move in and out of the soil. However, when rain heavily, water fills up the space occupied by the air. In this situation, animals living in the soil have to come out. That's why you see many insects and many bacteria and many small organisms during rainy season, because now their burrows, which is inside the soil, is filled with water. Okay? Have you ever wondered why all the oxygen in the atmosphere does not get used up through the large number of organisms are consuming it? Because it is a cyclic process. Organisms are consuming that oxygen and plants are giving us that oxygen back by the process of photosynthesis. Okay? How does oxygen in the atmosphere replaced? As I discussed, let us discuss in detail. In chapter 7, we read about photosynthesis. In this process, plants make their own food and oxygen is produced along with it. Okay? Plants also consume oxygen for respiration, but they produce more than they use. That is why we say plant produce oxygen. They use oxygen also like us for respiration, but they will make up that oxygen in large quantity. So they are replacing that oxygen. It is obvious that animal cannot live without plant. Similarly, plant cannot live without that animals also, because they need carbon dioxide and we are providing that carbon dioxide. They would consume more than carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. You can see both need each other. It's a mutual relationship. We need plants and plant needs us. But plants are not harming us, but we are harming them. We are cutting plants, okay? We can see both in each other, as the balance of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is thus maintained. This shows the interdependence of plant and animal on each other. We can now appreciate how important air is for our life on the earth. Are there any other use of the air? Have you ever heard about the windmill like this? The wind makes the windmill rotate. Windmill is used to draw water from the tube wells, and nowadays we use this for production of large amount of electricity also. Air help in the movement of the sailing yacht, gliders, parachutes and aeroplane also. Bird use this, bird, bat and insect use this air for flying. Okay, air also help in dispersal of the seed and pollen grain. We have studied that in our chapter Getting to Know Plants. Air plays an important role in water cycle also, right? We have studied that also. So these are the uses of the air, and our chapter is basically over. Let us study exercise part. What is the composition of the air? We have studied the composition of the air. Different components of the air are oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, dust particles, and many more others also. Which gas in the atmosphere is essential for respiration? Oxygen. How will you prove that air supports burning? By that activity in which we have lit up the two candles, one in the presence of the air, one in the closed vessel, one in the open vessel. In the closed vessel, the candle will blow off after certain time, which indicate that that air is necessary for burning. Okay. How will you show that air is dissolved in water? We have discussed this by one activity. You can refer to that part of this video. How does a lump of cotton wool shrink in the water? So question is, lump of cotton wool shrink in the water. Why is this thing happens? Because the air that is present inside that cotton, when it is not inside the water, but when we dip it inside the water, air will escape and that cotton will shrink. The layer of air surrounding the earth is known as atmosphere. The component of air used by green plant to make their food is carbon dioxide. List 5 activities that is possible due to presence of the air. You can do this question by your own. It's creativity question, so you can do it by your own. How does plant and animal help each other with the exchange of gases in the atmosphere? Basically, you have to show in this question that how plants and animals are interdependent on each other. So, plant need oxygen for survival, for breathing, for respiration, and they will release carbon dioxide. Plant need carbon dioxide for photosynthesis and they will release oxygen. So there is a cycle between these two. Okay, so this indicates the interdependence of these two plants and animals on each other. So students, our chapter is basically over. We will meet in our next video. Thank you for now.